Oh, we've got more.
Daytona, jeez. Oh,
okay, here we go. Here we go. Do we have any legitimate alternatives? I'm going to go something that, again, I think so far my choices have been story-based and era-based. They're from the same era. This one, not so much at all. I have gone for the Parmigiani Fleurier GT chronograph. Wow, look, this has a lot going on. This is not as simple or potentially as simple and elegant as a Daytona. It's certainly not as slim, but it's a panda. It has a super racy feel compared to the new Tonda PF collection, which is this entirely new aesthetic. So we may see, this may be an endangered panda, because this style of Parmigiani with that style of logo, I suspect is not long for this world. But so Parmigiani's get one while you can. Parmigiani, in terms of the quality of the watchmaking, let's put it in the God tier unimpeachable category. I find that this watch gives me Daytona feelings. However, again, if you're a watch lover and you see someone wearing what appears to be a panda, and then you go across the room and say, oh, look at that dial. We have an amazing pyramid dial execution similar to a Laureato. We have that big date at 12, the symmetry of the way this all comes together. I think this is a great alternative. What do you think, guys?
I'm pleased that you can around with your own kind of criteria. I'm like, you give me shit for doing
I reserve the right to be inconsistent.
And, and exactly more so than George's Calatrava alternative not connecting. This is a cool shout, but there's nothing Daytona about it, apart from the fact that the sub-dials are different from the
panda, the color configuration.
And it's a chronograph. Okay. But apart from that, it's...
Well, hey, we've all stretched. the boat's been...
But it's a cool shout. That's what I'm trying to say. It's a cool shout. George, do you want to go?
I'm going to bring something. You talk about thin. I'm going to bring something that I absolutely love, and that is the Finissimo Chrono. You're talking about thickness. This is thin. This is... Now, what I'm going to say is this gives you that Daytona flex.
Yeah.
That gives you the wrist flex that you go, boom, and it's a chronograph. It is designed. It's amazingly designed. Look at that movement. The whole thing, that for me is an alternative to a Daytona.
And it's not a manual wind. You look at that and say, hang on a second. Oh, I don't see a micro rotor. I don't see a... You know what it is? It's a peripheral rotor.
Yeah, it goes around the edge.
Gorgeous.
It's like a monorail.
I mean, Bulgari is on fire, and this for me is, we talk about flex.
Yeah.
Daytona is a flex at the moment, and this for me is even more.
You got a second time zone as well, which is just awesome.
Well, look, I love the titanium. I love the thickness of this. It's razor sharp, and it's a razor sharp watch. This is an alternative, and it is available to a degree.
Sure. Yeah, to a degree. Yep.
Cool. So you got to fill.
But you see, I brought a thin watch. You talked about thickness and all that stuff. I mean, I've
got to find a card to respond to that.
We've got to get some new cards.
This is my card to respond to that. I don't really have anything to say. If I throw that card out, it means you've won. Oh, boy. We've really lost our edge, I think. I just feel like we've come back and, you know, we're just riding high on our success as the number one watch podcast in the world.
Where the fuck are we the number one watch podcast? I mean, where?
Yeah, with George Bamford in it.
So we're supposed to come to the table with Daytona alternatives.
Let's get little bro in the
you
table.
Came with some cheese company, and then you came with some...
some cheese company.
Parmigiani. It's a joke that's a silly complete joke. Loses.
So this is the most boring alternative for the Daytona. However, it is without the best alternative to the Daytona. Unfortunately, this is probably harder to get than the actual Daytona itself.
I know. You're not meeting the breed.
But also, this is more retro. I for me, that the no crown guard, the riveted bracelet.
You're absolutely
right. There's a lot of crap about this that you just wake up. I'm like, that's innovation, and this is wake up. Wake the f*** up and do something like that.
I have to agree with you, George. I have to agree with you. This, for me and my styling, this is gorgeous. If I lived the life that I wanted to live, then I would have the Bulgari on my wrist. Because I think the Bulgari is fucking awesome. Yeah. but being Captain Boring, this is the number one alternative. But
come on, guys, we're talking about the most famous tricompax chronograph in the world, the Daytona, and you've brought a buy. Give me a try.
Thank you for watching, and we love audience participation. We love everything that you do with About Effing Time. And thank you, and we're back! Yes, baby!
Woo! Boom. Like, subscribe, and see you next time.